Hey, what's up, guys? Today we're gonna talk about how components communicate in React. Basically, parent to child, grandparent to grandchild, siblings, these relationships where they either pass information via property or event. And by the way, this is a much larger series on React. And if you're not following from the beginning, you can do so. I will provide a link here. So you can do that. And welcome to techsith. Right, so let's start with a brand new project. I'm gonna use create a React app to do so. The name of the project is going to be React Component Communication. All right, it takes a few seconds. All right, so we have created this new project, and what I'm going to do, go into this app.js and remove all the garbage first. So this would be our parent, and then we need to create a child. So what we're going to do is in the source folder, we can create a folder called components, and inside the components, we can create another folder called parent to child. Inside, we are going to create a child.js. So this would be stateless component. If you don't know much about modules, I have a tutorial so you can learn in detail how all this works. But we created our child component. Now let's understand how parent and child usually communicate. In React, you have main containers. So our app component is our main container. It could be a separate route or anything, but which holds usually the state. But that's not always true. But usually your main container would hold the state, and you'll have like other small component, the ch children components. That would be more like a presentation component, which would be stateless component like this one. So the fact is, there could be two possibilities. One of these stateless components can be a third-party component. So when they're designing this third-party component, they have no idea about your app. So we need to keep this component as abstract as possible. Just like a parent-child relationship where parent is responsible for their children. First of all, parent provides what children need, the food, shelter, and all that stuff, right? And if the child wants something done, they can just point, and then the parent will decide what that action should be. So here we're gonna do the same thing. So let's build a component, a button simply, and which is wrapped by a div. So button, all right. Now this button needs some title, but again, it's going to be provided by the parent. So the button would say whatever parent provides. So parent would provide props. Props could be anything. So the child would assume, okay, there should be a title. So I can say props dot title. And again, child doesn't know what this title is going to be. Similarly, when you click on this button, you can have an onClick event. We don't know what it's going to do. So I can call it, let's say, do whatever. Basically, child is pointing finger, and then parent would interpret, okay, what they really want to do with this event when somebody clicks on this button. So things are pretty abstract in here. Well, this should be props dot do whatever. Now let's use this child in our app component, which is our parent. Let me just remove this logo first. And here I have to first import the child. So I can say child from, this is inside components and parent to child. And inside I have a child. So here I can use my child. Now I need to provide two things. This child needs a title, and it needs to satisfy this event. So it's a parent's responsibility to do that. So we're going to create a state here. Let's call it state equal to, and it will have a title. And we can have some placeholder title call, let's say placeholder title. And we can pass this title to this child by calling title equal to this dot state dot title, right? So it's passing as a property. So the properties are passed down from parent to child. What about the event? So this has an event called do whatever. Events are often, they're passed down, but they're triggered upwards. This is needs to be passed as a property, but once somebody clicks on it, it will propagate upwards. So we can create a new event here, which would be here inside the app component, equal to. Now we need to, as a parent, we need to have some responsibility to build this event. And so the event is going to be here. So I can say, let's say this child is going to change the world. We can say, change the world. And so this would be, you can have a new title. And all it's going to do inside is set the state. So we can say this dot set state, and it's going to be new, let's say title, it's going to be new title. That's all it's going to do. So when you click on it, it will basically run this function. Now remember, I mean, if you're following this tutorial series, then we actually learned how to pass argument to events. And you can do it this way. So you can say, so this will be this dot change the world dot, we need to bind it to this, and then we can pass a new title here. We can call it new world. So let's look at it in detail. So the child has onClick event, which basically takes this do whatever property from the props that's provided by the parent, and it's going to execute that. But that event is going to propagate upward, which will translate into change the world event in the, and so the parent will execute this event, and it will set the new title, which would be new world. And then that title is going to be passed as a property to the child in this part. So now let's execute this. So I'm going to say npm start. Okay, so we have this button here, placeholder title, which is default. If I click on it, oh, nothing happens. Something is wrong. The issue is do whatever is not spelled correctly here, which I often do. So I save it, and I save this as well. Now if I click on it, it works. So right now we have app.js as our main parent, and then we have a child. Now let's make app.js as a grandfather, and we introduce a parent, and then parent would have child inside. So all I'm gonna do is create a new file called parent.js, which I need to import, which will be also stateless component. I need to import React, and I can say parent. And so the parent would have a child, but it will be wrapped with a div. And inside, all I'm going to do is child. And I need to still import the child here. So I'm say import child from. And they are the same level right now. So this would be a child. All right. And inside the app component, instead of child, now I need this to be a parent. And instead of importing child here, I need to import parent here. And this would be from the parent. All right, so how do I pass? So now the app is a grandfather, right? It needs to pass this to parent, and the parent needs to pass those property and some of its own if he wants to. So the simple way to do is if I want to pass everything that the grandfather is passing, I can just simply use spread operator. And the syntax is pretty simple. So here I have props, and I can simply do this dot 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 props. And this should actually pass everything that is coming from grandfather to the child. So if I save it, and let's see if it really works. So if I click on here, it really works. So it did pass everything. Now let's say if I want to pass an additional property here, I can pass, let's say x, y, z here equal to, you know, x, y, z if I want to pass to the child. And that should go, let's say title is the x, y, z. I can x, y, z. Right, so it passes everything that the grandparent has passed, and it has its own property added. So now I have XYZ here. Now let's say, how do siblings communicate? So for that, we don't really need to have two children. We can have, you can use the same child. The child will remain as it is. And again, it's oblivious to the world. It doesn't really know what the outside world looks like, except all he cares about it what really wants. It wants some title, and when it clicks on event, something needs to be done. The parent, however, will have two children. Now I cannot pass the same props because they might have a different requirement. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm going to create two separate events. Parent would satisfy what child wants. So first shell, when it does do whatever, it will say, I want to change the world, because not all childs are not created equally. So the one will change the world. So this would say props.change the world event. And the second child can do something completely different. And he can say keep the world same event. And again, the title can be just title. And this should be the same for both of them. That should be it. Now, there should be props. Now let's do app.js. So the parent has to pass now two events. It needs to pass, the grandparent has to pass two events. So instead of do whatever here, change the world event equal to, which would be this event. So I can say this dot change the world dot bind this, and then the new world. And it can have another event called keep the world same event equal to this dot keep the world same dot bind. We haven't created this event yet, but we will soon. And we're gonna call it same world. Okay, so we have now two separate events that is being passed from grandfather. And so here we can create another event, and this should be this one, keep the world same. Well, the new title should be new title, so it should take care of it. Or I don't need this two events, because as you can see, they both look the same. So I can actually have the same event here and remove this one, because it doesn't, it's pretty abstract, right? It's just the different title is being passed. So now let's say if it works. Hopefully it should work. I have two events. First, when I click on one, they both change to new world. When I click on a second one, it changes. So basically it's communicating through this event where it's changing the sibling's title, you see? So this is how siblings communicate through parent. Usually within the same container, where you have a parent-child relationship, you should follow this rule. But let's say if you have one container and a second container and they want to communicate with each other, you can use some sort of an event emitter. So one would subscribe to that event, and the second would emit the event. And so that's how you can catch the information that will be like from any component to any component. But I would suggest that within the same container, if you want to communicate, usually you should follow this protocol. Okay, so I hope you learned something from this tutorial. And if you did, you can help three different ways. Obviously, you can like, subscribe, and provide a nice comment. Support the channel via Patreon. I'll provide a link here. And also, you can translate the video for me. You can find the information in the description, how to do it. It's pretty simple. And thank you.